What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Critical Overlord here. So it looks like we have our confirmation on what Laurie Strode's status and what role she will play in Halloween Kills will be. We also now know who, in fact, our new main character focus will be for Halloween Kills, per a news article that we watched a movie wrote up. A fan of theirs reached out to them, brought them this news. They wrote up an article about it because they found it in regards to, this comes to us from Total Film Interviews. They sat down with David Gordon Green recently and he explained, just gave some tidbits on the capacity of Laurie Strode's involvement with the narrative in Halloween Kills and how it'll be shifting a bit from her to a different character to follow this character and her development and how she's been affected by this whole ordeal with Michael Myers. So, as I talked about and speculated previously in regards to a theory, Allison Strode, or Allison Nelson rather, will be the one carrying the mantle from Laurie in Halloween Kills. Now, what that also does, with us now knowing that, that puts some better understanding in regards to the ending of Halloween 2018 and why it was like that. Basically, what David Gordon Green had to say about this is, he says the following: when we met Allison, she was a very relatable, lovely girl next door type of character. But Allison here, just hours later, she is ignited. She's in some ways leading the charge and is one of the most bloodthirsty in the group. Now, Allison is again played by Andy Matichak. She's going to be taking over a starring role for Halloween Kills, and she's bloodthirsty for revenge for what Michael Myers has done to not only her but her family as well. So with that in mind, I can tell you already that I'm excited to see what happens with this character and what she actually goes through in Halloween Kills, because that already just tells me that they are trying their best to pay as much attention to continuity as they can, because that makes a lot of sense given how Halloween 2018 ended. Halloween 2018 ended with us kind of having a little final shot of Allison and then flashing down to the bloody knife in her hand, showing us that she has some sort of trauma already established from what has happened already in this night. That's still not over because we have Halloween Kills and then we have Halloween Ends. Laurie Strode is going to be taking the back seat, similar to Sidney Prescott in Scream 5. Laurie Strode will be sending most of this movie in Halloween Memorial. What's going to happen is we're going to end up seeing a group of individuals who have not been around since the 1978 movie that we did not get to see in the 2018 film. Those, of course, being characters like Tommy Doyle, Lindsay Wallace, Marion Chambers, Charles Cypher, Sheriff Brackett. We're going to see all of them band together in what sounds like some type of lynch mob, and they're going to go after Michael Myers. Now, how much of a mob mentality that will actually be depicted as on screen, of course, we have to see, wait for the movie. But when I hear things like that, the one thing that I'm thinking of is that scene from Halloween 4 when those men at the bar, those truck drivers, they all band together and they want to go out and they want to hunt Michael Myers. I feel like that was such a wasted way to tease your audience, because that's something that I was excited about when I initially saw Halloween 4 as a young kid. That got me pumped. I thought we were finally, it's like a refreshing thing to see that in horror, when you have a group of individuals who are looking to take the fight to the antagonist. They're not afraid. They know what the costs are. They know what the risks are. They know everything involved. They don't care. They're going out there to protect their town, and they know that they might lose their lives in the process, but they're not going to back down to someone because Michael Myers bleeds just like they bleed. So that whole ordeal with Halloween 4, I feel like that was wasted because they didn't do anything. They just got killed in the back of a truck. But I'm hoping with this new mob mentality that we have sort of sound like we're going to get in Halloween Kills, and it sounds like Allison will be leading the pack, I hope this is somewhat of a different situation where Michael is still hunting, but while you're hunting, you have people hunting you as well. So Michael might have to do a little bit of, he might have to dig into his bag of tricks a little bit deeper in this movie, because Tommy Doyle looks like he's going to be going after him. Again, I've made it very clear that I would love to see Charles Cypher's character, Sheriff Brackett. I'd love to see Sheriff Brackett go after Michael Myers and confront him in some capacity regarding the death of his daughter, Annie, all those years ago. Allison, she, of course, is going to be the weaker one out of the group. Her and Lindsay, because Lindsay looks like, to the best of my knowledge, Lindsay looks like she's at this stage in her life. She has kids. She doesn't look to be up to much, because I'm just going off of what we've seen from her. I hope we find out what's been going on with Lindsay, and I hope it's something meaningful. Same as I hope we do get with Tommy. Same thing with Charles Cypher's character. I don't know why I keep saying Charles Cypher. His name is Sheriff Brackett in the movie. Marion Chambers, maybe we'll have some backstory of how she spent her final days with Dr. Loomis. Maybe she can shed some light on what happened with Dr. Loomis in a different capacity. But again, we now know that Allison Strode will be the one to kind of carry the mantle from Laurie in this movie. And then, of course, the torch would then probably get passed back down to Laurie for Halloween Ends, where she'll have her final showdown with Michael Myers, and they'll probably all die together. But what I can't wait to see is how exactly this young girl will be affected by this, because of the fact that Andy Matichak did do an amazing job in her role in Halloween 2018. I know a lot of people don't agree. They kind of think the character was annoying. But she has elements of Laurie from the 1978 movie. She's very, yes, innocent. Yes, very much into her schoolwork. Has a bad relationship incident happen, similar to how Laurie has a kind of like a bad relationship incident in the first Halloween movie. She doesn't have a boyfriend breakup, but she is like in a bit of a dating issue situation. Allison finds herself in that in the 2018 movie, and she's kind of like the only one who's more sympathetic toward Laurie, whereas I've stated in the past, Karen is the one who wants to shut Laurie down. She's just a crazy old lady. My mom's crazy. I don't want her brainwashing my daughter into all this stuff that I had to deal with growing up. She just wants to completely shut her mother out. Meanwhile, Allison is more understanding, wants to sympathize with her grandmother and recognize that her grandmother is the way that she is for a reason, and she's gonna get that. She now has a better understanding of that now, given what happened in the 2018 movie. She's now lost her friends the same way her grandmother lost friends 40 years ago to this same individual. So she has some type of sympathy, if not even more sympathy now for her grandmother, because her grandmother is in fact not as crazy as her mother makes her out to be. Her grandmother is just very overprotective, and now she has every right to be. She's justified in what she's done over the past 40 years. So Allison is going to be right here, I guess, leading things. She's going to be out to get revenge, of course, for her grandmother, Laurie, while she spends her time in the hospital for Halloween Kills. Now, of course, Allison herself, I don't see her going toe-to-toe with Michael Myers and coming out on top. I don't actually see those two characters facing off in this movie. If you're going to have Allison go toe-to-toe with Michael Myers, I see that occurring in Halloween Ends, at the point where Laurie Strode probably takes a fatal blow, which looks like she's been killed off, but then she'll come back in the end like Busta Rhymes in Halloween Resurrection. And then while Laurie's been presumably killed during Halloween Ends, when that happens, that's when we'll finally get that showdown between Allison and Michael to see how she will hold her own against Michael, because we know she can't outstruggle him. Definitely not. She'll have to definitely dig down and come up with different tactics to defeat him, because Michael would take her out with one blow, in my honest opinion. But I'm really looking forward to see how she leads this group, what type of leadership she has. Not to say that this is actually a literal thing, but she'll probably have the most investment in whatever mob mentality goes on in Halloween Kills, because of the fact that she wants to avenge not only the death of her father, she wants to avenge the fact that Michael tried to not only kill her, almost killed her grandmother, and now also getting back at Michael for what he did to her grandmother 40 years ago, because now she is in the better understanding that what her grandmother suffered 40 years ago and what she's been doing in response to that is justified, and she's going to see to it that her grandmother's mentality and her mindset and her ideologies all about Michael Myers are all going to be fulfilled through her when she sets out to try to take the boogeyman out herself, take him on. But of course, not alone. She's going to have the assistance from Tommy, Lindsay, Marion Chambers. I hope we get to see how this all plays out, and I hope it's in a mob mentality similar to how we almost got teased in Halloween 4. But let me know what you guys think about all this down in the comment section below. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe. Turn on post notifications so that you never miss a video. In the description, I have links to my social media accounts, my Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can message me there to let me know if there's any movies, news, or reviews you'd like me to cover in the future. With all that in mind, guys, I will see you in the next video.